Hello, everybody. What's going on? This is Will here. Need to How can I not talk right now? Reposition my mic. Anyway, this is our practical swordless run of Ocarina of Time. This is part 18, I do believe. I can't believe I'm keeping track. I have to do re-recording of the audio again. Yes, again. And I think it's acting up again. Oh, maybe not. I don't know. I'm just kind of watching like the wavelengths in the background. I think it's okay. Anyway. Okay, so we finally unlocked that door that I had to backtrack again to find the key for. And now we gotta do this little puzzle in this stuff. What is that stuff down there? It hurts you, but I don't even know, man. Could be like cotton candy for all we know. Anyway, you'll see this eye switch that's covered in ice. So what you have to do is you have to shoot an arrow through this torch in order to light the arrow on fire and melt it. And I missed. So that's great. But whatever, we can just be little cheaters, and we can just jump over here. And because we're smart, and we picked this up beforehand, we can just use Din's fire and melt it. There we go. Or if you decided for some reason to leave the forest temple unfinished and go do the water temple completely, then I guess you could, like, I don't know, use the fire arrows, I guess. But anyway, spoiler, those are weapons we haven't found yet. Oh, okay. So, as you can see, since we hit the eye switch, the corridor is all twisted. Oh, God. Okay, so we're going to go down here. And this is when things really start to remind me of Alice in Wonderland. You know, with this tiled floor. I don't know. It reminds me of both the chess board thing, and it kind of reminds me of the kitchen place that Alice is in the beginning of the movie. But, you know, when she turns, like, big and small and stuff. Anyway. I hear a Skaldera. I don't think this is where I'm even supposed to be, but... Skaldera, where are you? Where are you? Where you go, Branny? Where are you? Come here. I don't see him anywhere. So he must be, like, under the platform or something. I don't even know. Here. I'll try playing the Scarecrow song here. I haven't really explained this yet, but, as an adult, if Navi turns green and, like, goes over to a random area, what you do is you play the Scarecrow song and, Pierre will pop out of the ground and you can latch onto him with the hookshot. Actually, I think I saw the Skaldera just down there a second ago. Ah, what a bunch of balls. Whatever. We don't have time for that. I just wasted, like, a good minute. Just, like, sitting there, where's the Skaldera at? Where's the Skaldera? Will, watch out! The ceiling is falling down. Oh, really? Thanks for warning us. We totally just would've, like, ran out there last second. So as you can see, there are little holes in the ceiling that falls down. And basically what you're supposed to do is push down the switch I just pushed down to go to the door over there. And at the same time, you have to avoid being crushed by the ceiling. But as you can see, there's little holes in the ceiling and stuff. So there are little safe spots you can find. As you can see, the chest is actually 2 squares wide of a safe zone. So, I don't know. Looking back at it now, I don't even see how I screwed that up. I don't see how I could, like, ever screw that up. Give me some hearts. More freaking arrows, like, thinking we just shoot everything. Okay, so as you can see, there's a bunch of shadows on the ground, and there's a painting of a Poe sister. And if you hit the painting, this will fall down. So instead of having to hit all the paintings, you hit one and you have to do a puzzle. In the time limit, of course. And basically what you want to do is you want to make an image, obviously, of the painting up on the canvas. But there's like this fifth one that gets in the way, and it's really annoying. It just disrupts everything. Like, there's no point of having it there. It's just to throw you off, really. Just completely ignore that fifth piece that looks like a... I don't even know what it's supposed to be. I don't know, like a... I always thought it was like a bat or something, or it might be like a hand. I don't even know. I have no idea what it is. I guess it is a hand. Yeah, it is. It's a hand. It's a hand from the blue one. What the heck's up with that? But I don't know. You just match up the four, and then you can fight against the third Poe sister, which is no different from, you know, the other ones you've done. It's just the puzzle that's different. Other than that, it's the exact same fight. Oh, nailed by a bow. That's the name of a bow from a Final Fantasy Tactics, isn't it? The nail bow? It's got like... No, I'm thinking of the thorn bow. Never mind. I was thinking of like a bow that had like a bunch of these like spikes on it, but I think it's called the thorn bow, not the nail bow. No, nail bow teaches you the ability aim for arms, doesn't it? I'll have to LP that game sometime down the road. I love Final Fantasy Tactics Advance. I've never played the original one, or the one for DSA2. But, I don't know. I love the characters, and I just loved all the cute little graphics and stuff. I just love the Game Boy Advance for that. Oh crap, I missed! I just love the graphics on the Game Boy Advance. I guess it's just because it reminds me so much of the Super Nintendo. It's just great. Just freaking great. There we go, got rid of you. Alright. Pick up those arrows that we really don't need, but always nice to keep a max supply, I guess. So we're gonna hit you. Oh my god. You could have even used arrows. I think if you use arrows on them, it like knocks them back like 10 feet and you're like, holy crap. These are like Chuck Norris arrows or something. So we're back in the main lobby of the Forest Temple, and oh no, it's the Fort Ghost, is he crying over the dead of the other three? Oh no, come here, oh let me comfort you, come here. Oh my god, look at her, she's just like on the ground, she's like kneeling down, she's crying. With her eyes open apparently. Does she turn to face you? Oh my god, what the heck, she does. Oh, just because I jumped off that platform. What a weird camera angle. Okay, so this is another mini-boss. This is like the third one. And what you have to do is just shoot arrows at the right one. Because this fourth post-sister, I believe her name's Amy, she's going to split into four copies. But really, it's not that hard to do. It might have been hard at the beginning when 3D games were a completely new thing, and this actual puzzle was kind of a new concept among video games, but really you just look for the post sister that spins around once they all appear, and then you just shoot that one with an arrow. And only if you get all of them wrong, I think if you hit the wrong one, no, if you hit the three wrong ones before the right one, then this post sister will attack you, I think that's how it happens. But you can't like catch the rebound and like hit her with an arrow or your sword like you could with the other ones, because then she disappears like right after that and then does it again. So it's a new battle, I guess. So I guess that's why they have the mini boss music, because she's not like the other three. Look at all the restored all the fire and jumping in the great glass Wonkavator. Oh man, that'd be great if this was a Wonkavator. Okay. Oh god, this part always confused me when I was a kid. I think when I recorded this, I think I made it come off a little easier. I think it was a little easier than I remember, but I'm not sure. Just because I see how long the video is. Okay, so we're gonna go in here, we're gonna push this. So what this puzzle's all about is, you have all these big platform column things in the room. And I don't know how, but apparently Link can push the entire room. I have no idea how. I mean, he needs the golden gauntlets just to pick up a tower, but apparently he can push an entire room with his bare hands. Like, he doesn't even need the silver gauntlets for that. I don't know. Something I just never understood. Another reason why I think this whole temple is just really trippy and weird. Because of that, but I don't know. Maybe I'm just looking at things too deeply? Which is, again, it's a surprise, since it's me. I don't know. Get out of here. We don't need you. And I think there's one up... Yeah, there's a gold sculpture up here, so I'll get you. If I can hit you, there we go. You destroyed a gold sculpture. You got a token, proving you killed one, or something like that. Okay, we got 18. That's not bad. 18 sculpture tokens? It's not too shabby. I missed that one. That kind of bugs me. You know, looking back at it, like, I can't believe I just left that sculpture be. I really could have just, like, used my arrows and looked down. I shot, but, whew, I'm an idiot and I didn't do that, so. Yeah, and I think that's the last switch right there. Yeah, there it is. So now we just walk to the other end of the room. And the main passage to the boss room is opened. Since we cleared all the cages. Look at that. The boss, like, locks and chains look so cool. It's just like, man, what an iconic thing from my childhood. Those locks. When you finally got the boss key and got to the end of the temple, facing all those challenges and stuff. Okay, so, you guys are probably wondering why I equipped, like, an empty bottle of all things, but... DT, you know, one of my writers for PokeProfiles, or BlackShadowWolf777, he was asking me about, using the empty bottle in the Phantom Ganon battle. And, like, he always knew that you could use it, like, in the Ganondorf battle, but neither of us actually were 100% sure if it could be used in the Phantom Ganon battle. So I equipped the empty bottle just to see if we could actually use it. Whoa. And now we're fighting against the evil spirit from beyond. Phantom Ganon. So what Phantom Ganon here is going to do is this little ghostly guy here is going to warp himself into paintings, run down the road of the painting, and he's going to run back up the road of another one. And usually what he does is there'll be two of him in two different paintings, and you have to find out which one's the real one and shoot an arrow at him when he comes out the portal. I find this is probably one of the coolest Zelda boss battles. Although that one that I just played in Skyward Sword, that one was pretty cool. Crap! How did I dodge that? Holy cow, man. That boss battle from Twilight Princess. Skyward Sword was pretty cool. The, what's his name? I forget his name completely. Oh man, I just hung you right there. I forget his name. He's like the fire one. He like looks like a big spider and he's like made of like magma. And he has like crusting rock all over him and stuff. And you have to like throw bombs at him down to the end of the, down to the end of this, like, this big, like, hill. Like, it's like an incline. It's huge, and it's really cool. Dude, it works! Oh, yeah. Come on. Oh, man, that's awesome. Oh, that was way too freaking early. This thing just slashes a lot quicker than the, than the sword, so. Why do I keep missing you? Get over here. Look, I keep missing him. What is this? Jeez, how did that even work? I was like completely done slashing the bottle. Look. Oh, do I have to be farther away from? Oh, jeez, man. I'm gonna be dead. Yeah, do I have to be like farther away from him in order for it to really work? Oh man, look at this! Look at this! Oh man, we are tethering back and forth. Look at this. Oh. Oh, you suck! Oh, you suck! You suck! Oh my god! Oh my god, you suck. Oh, jeez. Crap. But yeah, there's like... Okay, what was I talking about? Oh yeah, the Skyward Sword, the fire temple thing, boss battle. It's like this thing, and it's like... It looks like a spider or something. And it like walks up... Okay, wait. What am I trying to explain? Okay, so the... it's just... Oh, it was such an exciting boss battle, I don't even know where to start. I died! Oh yeah, right, I had a fairy, I'm fine. I can proceed with my explanation. So what happened is, so the whole boss battle takes place on a big hill, right? Like, it goes upwards. And what you have to do is you have to keep the spider guy down at the bottom of the hill, because once he's down at the bottom of the hill, he'll start trying to suck you in to, like, attack you because he's on the bottom, I guess. I guess he just feels more in his element when he's at the bottom or something? I don't know. but, like, what he does is, as he's climbing up the hill, he's gonna shoot fireballs at you, but once he gets to the bottom, he tries to suck you up, like, King Dodongo style. So what you have to do is, while he's climbing up the hill, you have to throw bombs at him to make him combust, right? Because the bombs are very sensitive to, heat. So, you throw it at his body and he explodes and he like curls into a ball because he's scared and he rolls down the hill. That actually kind of reminds me of the worms, like those like centipede worm things with the pinchers in Wind Waker, I guess? Yeah, because you like hit them when they like have their pinchers opened up and then they curl into a ball. So he curls up into a ball and then he rolls down the hill, and once he's down at the bottom he starts trying to suck you in. So again, like King Dodongo style, dude, we killed him! That is awesome! Look at that! So anyway, so then when he's at the bottom, he just tries to, like, suck you in, right? And then what you have to do is, of course, like, if you played any Zelda game before, you know what happens next. You have to throw a bomb into his mouth, and then he gets stunned, and, like, all of the crusty stuff, like, on his body, like, bursts off, and he's just, like, pure, like, molten stuff. So then, like, his eye is, like, exposed and stuff, so then you have to go over and slash his eye. I just thought it was really cool because of the terrain. Like, it is an old concept, but the terrain you're on, like, completely changes the way you have to do it. It's just, I thought it was genius, to be honest. Anyway, geez, we're done here already. It took me that whole time. In the original recording, I did, like, that British impersonation again, like, that really bad, thick one of Ganondorf, but didn't get to do it this time because I was too busy explaining. Anyway, I am rambling. That's it for this episode, guys. I hope you... Look at that, we got our heart container and everything. I hope you all have a very good life, or afterlife if you're really, really wimpy Phantom Ganon, who lost the bottle of destiny. And a tiny butter knife looking to kill me in the next episode. Peace.